So some, let's say somebody wants to maybe reduce their chemical exposure to start with. I think if they really look at how much they're exposed to every day, it'd be a little bit overwhelming when you get up in the morning from all the products that you use. How does someone start living a little cleaner? I mean, where would you suggest that?
So this is how I suggest people begin, is take a walk through your house. So start in your kitchen. What are you eating? Mm-hmm. What kind of cleaning supplies do you have in there? What kind of water are you drinking? So you can get a water filter. So that's better than buying water. Mm-hmm. You can start eating organic food. Start washing your vegetables more than you do habitually. You can also look in the bathroom, for example, and look at your own personal body care products and cosmetics. This is a huge source of exposure. And you can look in the garage and you can look in the garden. So you take a walk through your house and kind of do it one section at a time. And there are some great resources. I have a website called Integrative Cancer Answers where we talk about this a lot. It's all free information. There's also the Environmental Working Group, EWG.org. And they have a small website connected to them called the Cosmetics Database, where you can look up, say, if kids and you want to buy sunscreen for them, you can look up what is the safest for your child. So you have to be proactive, you have to educate yourself, but a lot of times the staff at natural food stores in your own neighborhood are knowledgeable and can point out products that are safer and good alternatives than the ones you already use. So there's a lot of resources and ways, but I just have people walk through their house and start room by room cleaning up what they're exposed to for the things we have control over, right?